here is our first proper date. Two tickets. You and me are going to a ball.
First time you and me ever go out as a foursome?
What, me? Go to a ball?
He must hate me. Keeping him away from her.
Okay, here he comes.
Go, go, go!
He's not a lowlife, Mrs. Hull. He's a very sweet man. He's just not around.
I can't go at 5 mile an hour for more than 90 metres.
How far are you going, mate?
On, my friend, till I find a homeland for these, my people.
I think the time for balls may have passed.
No!
What?
Prawn mousse. That's what I'm missing. I've got smoked salmon samosas, caraway scones, mango dipping red cabbage bowls. The one thing I haven't got on this menu is something to do with prawns.
Laura, do you have any idea what it does to the male ego during lovemaking to know that his partner's lying there thinking about small pink shellfish?
Why on earth should I be interested in the male ego?
We were about to engage in the most important union a man and a woman can achieve.
You were, sweetheart. You know I don't believe in sex on a you carry on and give us a wave when you get to the top basis.
Well, where were you?
On the verge of Waterloo, okay, Hodge? My Waterloo. My first catering job for 160 conference guests.
Right. Well, have fun.
Yeah, that's women for you. Use you and chuck you out. Don't worry, mate. You're better off without them.
I've not been chucked out. I've just been told that prawns are more important than sex.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't know. I've only ever had prawns.
Those, Eric. That's what she intimated. A prawn is more important to her than having sex with me.
Oh, well, come on, be irrational.
Well, do you think it's prawns in general she's talking about, or just one particular prawn?
Okay, lads, what'll it be?
Can I have some prawns, please?
Prawns? What do you think this is?
A fish shop?
Do you know, I've been saying that for 20 years and it's still funny.
12 pounds of washed Scandinavian prawns, please.
Sorry, mate, I only got the washed Morecambe ones. The Scandinavian lot are still in the shower. You just can't stop them ticking about with the towels. Ticking about with the towels.
There's one thing I hate, it's a happy Welshman.
Yo, Eric.
Hey, what's this? 36 hours and still the same cat?
Hey, lads, have you seen this month's issue of the Northwest Local Retailers Journal? Jack Dominic Games, the manufacturers of the new board game Gurkha Tank Battle, report an unusually healthy response to the new item, pushing sales 37% higher against the company's own first quarter projections.
You have no idea what that means, have you?
No, but I know it's good. Because there's a picture of me with Jack Dominic's first success written all over it.
Do you have to smile like that?
Eh?
You always manage to look less like someone who's just invented a board game and more like someone who's just been presented with one by a charity.
Yeah, well, my accountant says my royalties are already about 8 grand, Mr. Smartass, so I can smile how I like.
8 grand?
I can pay this year's rent and still have easy enough left over for that Harley Davidson.
What Harley Davidson?
Picking her up Saturday morning. Lady Linda, she's called.
No, hold on. You can't, not Saturday morning. No, we've got the executive stretch out, we're bound weekend. It's some public relations thing for employers.
Oh, so hold on. My choice is I can spend my weekend seeing if a load of computer programmers can cross a river using 3 broom handles and a bog roll, or cruise the countryside with 1200cc between my legs like Dennis Hopper. Let's see.
No, prawn mousse sounds fine. Bye, Laura.
Mummy, can you give this to Laura to give to Hodge?
I don't think Hodge needs a birthday invite, sweetheart.
Yes, he does.
You can't invite every man who's ever come once to the house. I know it seems a nice idea now, but you won't think that when some bloke from British Telecom beats you at pin the tail on the donkey.
Hodge hasn't come once, he came twice, and he came to school, and he does magic.
Kirsty, no.
I tell Rebecca he does magic.
Oh, you're an angel. Did you get the prawns?
Second bag. They're from Morecambe, sorry. Wouldn't worry, though. Most businessmen I know can't tell red wine from lager, let alone which coastal waters a prawn grew up in.
Oh, well, doesn't matter. These are only for the dry run.
You're having a dry run?
Well, I can't prepare in advance. No freezers. Got to do it all the night before. So, this weekend, we do a dry run to find out how long each item is going to take what?
I'm out doing executive stretch this weekend.
Oh.
You can't just rely on people always being around, Laura.
No.
I mean, well, just out of interest, have you planned all that bit? The people bit? If it's bits of stuff, you're going to need waiters going round, aren't you?
Yeah, well, I presume that you and...
Me and Derry could help, I know.
And you won't?
Well, I will. Of course I will. But there's 100-odd people. You're going to need more than two, aren't you?
Yeah, well, Hey, I've got a budget. I'll advertise.
So it was all right in the end, Saturday night, wasn't it? Going to your ball. I mean, I know we only made it as far as the Happy Trucker Transport.
Eric, I was expecting an 8-course banquet and an evening's entertainment. I got a chip bap and Lloydie throwing the tops off tomatoes everywhere, shouting it's a spider.
You'd be good to meet Laura, though, didn't you? Did you get on?
Not really. What with her being a vacant prat?
Pardon?
She is a classic case of the only daughter in a family of brothers. The girl's effectively grown up with five fathers.
Really?
She does a little dull-eyed, lost phone in a thunderstorm routine and men end up running round for her.
No, you'd never guess you just passed your chance psychology exams.
Mr. Carew.
Yeah.
Dawn Lomax from the college. I've come to look at the flat.
Oh, yeah, Dawn, right. Come on in. Bit early in the year, isn't it, for students?
No, well, I'm staying up in Roker over the summer, trying to get a job.
Oh, got you. Right, yeah. Well, it's 200 a month.
200? For a one-bed flat?
Two. I usually have two students in there. Have a look.
Right.
Eric, by the way.
Oh, yeah, Pete.
So you're a musician,
eh? Yeah, I know. It's the beard, isn't it? People always say that. You got a beard, you must be a musician.
Well, yeah. And a saxophone around your neck.
Oh, God, yeah. You know, that's weird. It just becomes part of your body, this thing. It's like you forget you got it on.
So you're a professional?
Oh, there's a group. We play this kind of African funk, free jazz fusion.
Oh, great. Yeah.
And then during the day, we record backing music for karaoke tapes. Just doing Nelly the Elephant.
Right.
Bit of a bummer, really. But you gotta eat.
I mean, it's great. So it's two bedrooms, kitchen, diner, and bathroom.
Yep, that's it. Well, and the other bit.
Parties out here. Bring lights through.
Don't,
a table.
Don't.
Have breakfast. Get a mattress. Eric, you could sleep on this. Out here under the stars, counting the satellites.
Look, don't fall in love with it. Come on. 200 quid's 200 quid.
No, it's not. 200 quid's 100 quid. If there were two of us.
30 quid for 4 hours.
Could you stick one up on the school notice board? Some of your sixth formers might do it.
30 quid for 4 hours, some of the staff might do it.
Yeah, I guess so. Is this any use? If you're looking for a summer job?
Deleuze catering?
Yes, 30 quid for 4 hours.
No, Tammy. You see, the thing is, if I can't get you to move into that flat with me, I'm going to need a full-time childminding job. So I better keep free for interviews.
You just don't work for Laura, do you?
I'd rather eat soil.
I thought so. Listen, about this flat, I thought...
I mean, when I said moving in, I didn't mean, like, sharing towels or your side of the bed moving in. It was more like students sharing a flat. Just to clarify. Mm.
Hey, hey, hey. Here they come. Welcome to the slaughter.
Right, little word. These business people have come of their own free will to discover the benefits of being in the TA. I don't want any laddish intimidation, unnecessary harshness, or rubbing of hands saying, welcome to the slaughter, okay? Right.
Team C, apparently we've got 2 assistant project planners, 3 systems managers and 2 special operations advisors. Amazing. These people all work in offices. Why do you make it sound like they work in the cockpit of a spaceship?
Because they all work in offices.
What's the matter?
It's just your brother's little comedy rat pack. Anyway, I've told them, no messing. They're going to the dormitories 1 hour after lights out and wake the team members gently. I don't want any dicking about.
Now, when I said no dicking about, maybe I didn't make myself clear.
Sorry, boss.
I want no more, absolutely no more dicking about. Right?
Sorry, boss.
Right. Okay, troops. 0800 hours. First mission, individual mini quiches. Synchronize watches. Let's go.
This is the rendezvous. Well done, Group C. You've just navigated yourselves 8 kilometres in the dark.
I'll go and gee up the stragglers. How are we doing back here, then?
How am I doing? Well, let's have a look, shall we, love? I got into a bed the size of a coffin for 30 minutes, got woken up by Jerry Cottle's bloody circus, then tramped 5 miles in the pitch black and it's not even breakfast time now.
Do you like it when people call me love?
What am I doing here?
I mean, come on, sweetheart. You tell the marketing manager of a sheet metal company how this is supposed to help him get his next contract.
Well, I think he'll find his organisational skills are
no.
Really.
I'll tell you why. And being as I'm in the row, up to me wedding tackling wet bracken, I'll be frank, all right? I'm here because I don't have long hair and breasts.
If you want long hair and breasts, I have a feeling you might have come on the wrong weekend.
No, it's the director's pet.
What? They all want breasts?
No, they all want women. All of a sudden, they want women everywhere so they can ching up their politically correct, oh, aren't we good boys point. But what happens to the fellas? They're being fobbed off on courses like this while all the girls sit at home being fast-tracked. Now, I've got nothing against equality, love, but not when it's me that's bloody losing out.
God, stop the watch, stop the watch. All right, all right. 10:16, individual mini quiches complete. Item 2, smoked salmon samosas. Ow!
God, sub team leader. Come on, Pete. Play them like train tracks. Pretend you're a chuff chuff.
Look, it gets wider as they go along, Dave. They keep falling through, okay?
So, Dave. You reckon women come off all right in these all male environments, then, do you?
You're not an hairy armpit, are you?
Pardon?
You're not sister of the hairy armpit. I'm telling you, got no time for feminists.
Pester you a lot, do they?
Well, they kick up a stink if they're discriminated against, but I don't mind taking it if they think breasts can help them get up the ladder.
Well, I think any woman whose breasts help her climb up ladders deserves some kind of recognition.
Come on, sweetheart, face it. What do those two stripes mean you are?
A sweetheart. One means you're a love, two you're a sweetheart, three you're a pet.
So, what do you do?
Pardon?
The job, you know. Are you manager level at work?
I don't work, actually.
You don't work?
So what, Dave?
So, you got no experience in management or anything, but you can come out here and push straight to the front.
Okay, Dave, over you go.
What have you cooked today?
Oh, nothing much. Just a bit of sushi.
Look at that. God, I wish I could cook. Really makes your meal times here, doesn't it, bringing your own stuff?
Oh, I don't know. Somehow it's not the same eating lunch without Loini.
What do you mean?
I really miss that sparkling conversation you used to get over meals.
Like what?
Have you finished that? Hey, are you not eating that, man? You're not chucking that art, are you?
All right, Ali.
All right, listen, do you fancy doing me a little favour?
And the final type of booby traps are the pressure-on, pressure-off devices, rigged to make contact when you put the pressure on it, or you take the pressure off it. Right, if the leader for this stand comes with me, I'll give the briefing. Who's the team leader, sir?
Dave, I think.
Fine. Dave?
What are we looking for, anyway?
A hostage. I said, don't you listen? There's a hostage doll here. Somewhere. Some kind of doll.
The stairs! There's a tripwire! It's all right! Take long, did it? I found it. 35 seconds, lad. It's a bloody miracle this lot won in the golf if they can't even hide a doll in it.
Now, when I said no dicking about the second time, I obviously didn't make myself clear. Shut up. Have you any idea how much those Italian plum tomatoes cost?
They were left over from lunch, boss.
Then they should have gone in the slop bucket, not been arranged down a toilet so whoever lifted the lid got a bombful detonated in his face.
Boss.
Don't protect them, Corporal. It was a cold-blooded trap. Now, come on. Who pulled the hostage's arm off and wedged it under the lid?
Private Gad, sir.
Right.
On my orders. Sorry.
Right, well, don't just stand there. Go and wash the wall down before the next group see it and pass out!
Before you bore me out, can I just say I did it because this is a PR exercise and I couldn't have a slanging match, but the guy had it coming to him. Boss.
Why?
He was implying I got treated differently because... on the grounds of sex, and so these stripes weren't worth anything.
I see.
But I know that's no excuse, and I take responsibility, so...
Ali, between you and me, if some grunt of a civvy had said that this wasn't worth anything, I'd have put the tin tomatoes down the bog and left them in the tins.
but it isn't an excuse, boss.
It's okay. It is to me.
But it isn't an excuse. And if it was those lot, they'd be in here getting hammered for dicking about. So
I consider it an excuse.
Well, so you were just going to let them off and walk out? That's what was going to happen just then.
No, because I thought they were just dicking about with tomatoes.
So I was.
No,
so
you weren't.
I was.
There were different circumstances.
They were the same tomatoes.
But it was different for you, okay? Now,
so Dave was right then.
What?
I can fine go to Dave in sick bay. Actually, mate, Dave, yes, you were right. You do get treated differently.
Yes, you do, Corporal, when it's about pride, which happens to be something I think is important, and that's how I make a judgment. And it will be the same for any one of those lot, so don't tell me who I should be bawling out, thank you very much, because I can decide that. I can, if you think I'm the kind of officer as well who wouldn't bawl you out just because you're a woman, then I don't know why you agreed to be attached to this platoon at all, because I'm telling you, I wouldn't. Of?
Laura?
Oh, wow. Can I, That is fantastic. Okay, it's crap. It's really crap.
Can't do it, Hodge. She's relying on me. I can't do it.
They taste fantastic.
But that's not enough, is it? Took me 28 hours just to do that lot. I did a rough calculation. And to get those canopies ready for 100 people this Saturday, I needed to have started at about 1956.
Well, you still have the whole of this week.
I've told you, I've only got one afternoon. Because I haven't got enough refrigeration, have I? Because I'm just starting.
Stop hugging yourself.
Well, ending more like.
Put your hands down and stop hugging yourself.
This is finito, isn't it?
Look, people who hug themselves start rocking backwards and forwards. Next thing, they're in a padded cell with electrodes attached.
Well, it helps me, okay, Hodge?
Well, it doesn't help me, okay? Because I hate seeing people doing it. So just stop it.
Sorry. Just don't know what I'm going to do.
What are you doing here? All right, Spock. Sorry about
Shh. Keep your voice down.
When I've got a rifle, I am Spock. When I've got a mug, I'm Mr. Matlock.
You don't teach them ones, do you?
Those? No, sadly. That's the junior school. That's the age when they're actually quite nice. Well, the ones I teach will currently be scrabbling around the edge of the hockey pitch trying to find hallucinogenic mushroom. You can take them this afternoon if you want. We'll swap. You do a double on the Franco-Prussian War, and I'll go back and sell grass seed. Hello?
Sorry.
Can I help?
Yeah. Listen, I don't like asking, mate, because she's my girlfriend. I know it's crap getting other people involved, but it's something you're good at. And, you know, I'd help you if you wanted gardening advice or general...
What do you want?
Could you give us hand cooking Friday night?
Okay, well, if anything comes up, that's 719041. That's a friend's number. I'm staying with a friend at the moment. Okay. Thanks, anyway. That's it. Three agencies all the same. We've got enough females, we've only vacancies for male childminders. 80 years campaigning for women and men to be allowed the same jobs, and what happens? They take ours. I feel strangely like Wile E. Coyote when he presses the plunger and the dynamite blows up at his end. I mean, why would anyone in their right mind want a male babysitter?
I have to say, all the people I've had from your agency so far have actually been women.
Ross.
But I decided I'd like Kirsty to have a little more adult male company.
Uh-huh.
Not that I desperately feel the need for a male hand on the tiller, but you know what I'm saying.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, there's no father around and you're trying to compensate.
I suppose if you boil things down, that's what would be left in the pan, Ross. Yes.
Sorry.
So, anyway,
they sent you my details.
They did.
What, out of interest, was it that made you ask for me?
Well, the abject lack of any other choice did play a part, Ross. Although I have to say I was intrigued by your, quote, ability to offer a wide variety of regional accents.
Eh?
Ross trained in English and drama at Manchester University.
No, they shouldn't have sent you that one. That's my other job. This one's got all about my practical experience helping in my mum's junior class.
Your other job.
It doesn't affect anything, Mrs. Scarry. I'm totally dedicated to...
What other job?
I just do voice work, recording, adverts, independent local radio. Omska Car Show, it's the motor show to go to. All that.
Yes, well, as long as you concentrate on this job while you're on my time, Ross.
Totally.
I'm sure Kirsty would love to spend Saturday learning to speak like a Cornish tin miner, wouldn't you? Now, this is where it'll be. Oh, I'll get the number.
Why aren't you here on Saturday?
I've got a seminar to organise, love, so Ross is going to look after you.
Why?
Because you can't come to a grown-up seminar.
Why?
As a parent, you will come to dread the word why, Ross. It is an endless vortex from which the only escape is the magic phrase, because I say so.
Because rotten seminars are boring. They're just boring, all load of adults talking in a big room and eating silly little things of food.
It's a party.
It's a kind of grown-up party, but really, really boring. So, would you really like to know how to speak Cornish?
I just really wanted that money. I'm doing something really crap at the moment, I know I am. I'm pressuring Eric to move out of home just because I've fallen in love with a flat.
He needs to move out of home.
Well, yeah, but he's only there because his dad's had this breakdown thing.
I'm not saying stop caring. I'm saying don't let him get stuck spending his life keeping someone else's plate spinning.
Ali loves the bloke.
But it's still ticking, sugar. The clock with Eric's name on doesn't stop. And you won't have done many favours when he hits 30 and turns around and thinks, what have I? Actually, out of all this lot, when I turn my pockets out, what have I actually done for me?
We're still talking about Eric here, are we?
I mean it, Ali. I'm not doing a Laura Deleuze. If I want that flat, I'll sort the money out on my own.
Me laugh. Look at that.
Don't touch that.
Look at that.
Leave it.
Come round now, he says there's a panic on.
That is the last one you have, okay?
How long have you been asleep?
What time is it?
9 o'clock.
Well, 8 minutes.
Thanks for coming, Lloydie. It's just I realised about 3:30 I hadn't really thought about.
We need some help with transport, mate.
Transport? No problem.
Right, now if we put the first load in...
What's this?
Cracker, isn't she? Lady Linda.
Yeah. Great. Smashing.
It's ideal. Because look, we'll have flaming no trouble putting this smoked salmon samosa on the back seat, will we? There you go, love. Sit tight. When you get moving, just hold on to his back.
Hey.
That means you only have to do 495 journeys.
Look, do you want help or not?
We want a car.
Yeah, well, I ain't got one at Mini.
Well, what happened to the Triumph Stag?
I don't know. They were just this bang.
Bang and it stopped. Fantastic.
Lloydie.
Well, it's okay. It's okay. I'll go with Lloydie so we can put the seat down in Spock's estate, okay? Let's keep calm.
No! Lloydie, will you slow down? I've got no helmet, all right?
Oh, you'll be all right. You never meet any police on these roads.
That's not the point.
Good, eh? I tell you, there's no feeling in world quite like this, is there?
How about falling off the Humber Bridge strapped to a freezer?
Simon, it should say small business seminar, pet. Small businessman seminar does sound rather like we're expecting hordes of 2-foot-high people with briefcases. Daniel, can you make sure access is open round to the rear gardens? The caterers need to use the back entrance.
All right, Mum. Do you know where the
waitress.
It's all right, Lloydie.
Hey?
It's all right, Lloydie.
The garden entrance.
Right, I'll go park up.
Hi-o.
I take it that wasn't Laura in there.
No, she's coming with the food. She set off the same time as us, which means she's probably just about coming to the end of her road by now.
I'd like to think you know why I'm doing this, Hodge. I presume you've realised under normal circumstances I wouldn't be using Deleuze catering.
I reckon probably a reward for keeping away from Kirsty. Kind of present for not turning up with presents. Or something.
As long as you know it's for you.
Janessa, how's she?
Fine and healthy and happy.
Man, it's Hamish McLaverty here. Now, you know what people say about us Scots being careful with our money? Well, people often ask me, Hamish, if you're in Birkenhead and you're looking for quality footwear, where'd you go? And you know, every time I say...
If you do that with that horse once more, it's going out the window.
Eh?
Ross, will you get out here?
What's the matter?
What do you think's the matter? What happens during any normal radio commercial session? Rosie's hungry, so she eats the grass. Only the grass happens to be my green pre-fade buttons, so I get 200 decibels of feedback down my ear.
Right. Sorry, Jerry. I'll. Kirsty. Come on, Sugar Plum. I said, stay on the settee.
You keep doing it wrong.
Yeah, because I'm nervous. Because this is my first ever advert for this very big company, and it's very, very important.
It's very, very boring.
Wow! Look! Some magazines!
Have they got Rosie and Jim?
Electronics World, Shortwave Magazine, the Northwest Local Retailers Journal. No, not really.
I want to go to the party then.
What party?
In the castle, Mummy's one.
No, it's not a castle and we can't go to that.
Why?
Because it's not allowed.
Why?
Because we can't.
Why?
Because I say so.
So can I ask Mummy why you said to keep it a secret about us coming here?
We might be able to go for a bit.
What do you mean you've knackered the hedge?
Well, it weren't my fault. All right. I just pulled Lady Linda up next to it and I were looking for a thing to kick down to prop her up. I couldn't find it. So I were kicking and kicking. Of course, problem with that thing is once she starts toppling over, you've had it. Good, though. I won't look over that edge normally. Smart gardens.
Thanks, boys. In there. Right. Has my waitress arrived yet, do you know?
Luke, I'm his mate. I help out. Why are you doing this?
When a girl needs a book, a girl needs a book.
I thought you said you'd rather eat soil.
Yeah, well, as the Maharishi said, he who want nice flat must eat soil. Pressure not your partner to move out of home when he's not ready.
Great. Well, that's perfect, Dawn. You look just like something out of a Harrogate tea shop.
A mug.
Janetta, I cannot tell you, this place is inspired. Good. Are you all set?
I think so. Only change is one of the speakers has pulled out. Dave Basker, UBK Sheet Metals.
Oh?
Apparently he went off on one of those army course things last weekend and his secretary said she doesn't know what happened, but he suddenly phoned in to take the week off.
So what? Is there a hole in the schedule?
Oh, no. Actually, it's really worked out rather brilliantly. Someone in the development office rang an old friend who... This is him, said he'd stand in. Never dreamed of approaching someone of his standing in the first place. But it appears that whatever the army did to old Dave, we've banked a bit of a local business celebrity. Also, between you and me,
The bloke is six on a stick.
Morning, ladies.
Morning.
Morning.
Come in peace. I'm heap sorry. You don't mind me coming in to see at the office?
It's a hotel. Anyone can come in. Have a brochure.
Yeah, okay, Carl. I was out of line. I'm sorry. It appears I'm snapping at everyone at the moment. I think it's being 30 next month. You get raw nerves coming up like varicose veins.
You do know that I wasn't making
out. I know what you were saying and what you weren't saying. Because I've been over it all, and yes, you were right. You should be proud. I just didn't realise that I was.
Good.
So listen, right, I've been thinking about it, and seeing as it's something I've got and I'm proud of, well, like Dawn says, don't sit around on your rear end. Well, she's sort of... Carl, if I thought about going for a commission, am I wasting my time? Come on, tell me honestly.
A commission?
Yeah. Do you think I'm up to it? Be brutal.
I think you know what I think.
I don't think I do.
You know I think you're about the best soldier in that building.
You'd back me up then?
Yeah. I'd back you up.
Thanks, Carl.
Don't touch. That is forbidden fruit.
It's smart.
That is the last one you have, right?
Does the mango dip go in there?
Yeah, in the cabbage bowl. Pour it in.
Hey!
Lloydy!
Hey, Hodge, you're all right? We've got a helmet for way back now.
Look, no one has asked you to stay here. You can go home now. I mean, you've turned up on a bike, fallen off it, left a crater the size of a meteorite. That is quite a productive day for you.
Makes me laugh.
HR minus 15.
Right, crudités out, prawn roulade out.
Right, prawn roulade. Hodge? Prawn roulade. Hello?
I forgot she'd be here.
Who?
Janetta. Flying about after Laura. I forgot there was her flaming conference.
Hey, now, come on, you've forgotten all that. Don't start picking at stitches.
Eric, it's a bit hard to forget you're the father when you just run into the mother.
Well, avoid her. I mean, keep it in proportion. It is only Janetta. It's not the apocalypse. It's not like Kirsty's actually here herself.
Yeah, yeah.
Where's Laura? Just out of interest.
You know, I was thinking... She said she was changing into her work clothes about three quarters of an hour ago.
Right, here we are. That's better. Okay, Dawn, can I show you where I want the dips?
Listen, you would tell me if I was overdressed, wouldn't you?
Pardon?
I mean, what happens at the end? Are we all getting on a yacht or something?
Oh, this? Oh, no, it's just because I'm the boss, really. I ought to look the part.
Well, seeing as I'm the servant, would you prefer me to stuff a cushion up my back and drag one leg round?
Hey? That's it. We're going. Oh, my God, we're going. Eric!
Hmm?
You two, the doors, please, can you?
Hey?
We have to go open the doors, Eric.
Listen, Dawn.
I'm not moaning, I'm fine, look.
Yeah, very good. Listen, start of the year, I made this plan, Operation Eric, about getting a job and then moving out and then getting a relationship going. Of course, BMA, it all happened in the wrong order. It's still all going to happen.
Are you saying you want to move out?
Yeah. I think, yeah. No. Yeah.
The doors. Eric!
Yes, Nathan.
Greg, that was fabulous.
Great speech, Greg.
So funny. That bit about marketing in Europe and the meeting with the Danish board of...
Anyway, nice to see you again, mate. Great, that.
Royce, call me.
Wine, books, madam, sorry.
Do you have time for a glass of wine? Or a bit of buffet?
What time is it?
I mean, 2:15. Don't, if you... you're probably having to rush off. Yes, you probably do, don't you?
Not necessarily.
Caraway's gone to need a fresh tray.
There's one there, ready to go.
I'm going low on Brie and Ann pinwheels.
Brie and Ann. Brie, where's the Brie?
Here, Spock, look at this.
What now?
Illogical, Jim.
Extraordinary.
You know, if the bomb dropped tomorrow and we had 2 minutes to get down the bunker, you'd still be prattling around with a gas mask going, "Hey, look, Spock, Darth Vader."
Hodge, do you think you can get your girlfriend away from her admirers to lend a hand, eh?
No, what?
The blog she's been with for the last 30 minutes. Can you...
I'll take that one. So we ended up standing with her around his ankles.
Prawn.
Sorry?
Prawn thing. In a roll. Mousse.
No, I'm fine, thanks. So, you're told before you meet her, don't ask her a question, right? The protocol is the Queen doesn't answer any questions from a commoner.
Is that right? I can't believe you've done this.
No, that's right. So, we're all stood on this yacht with these things, only not so nice. And we're announced as the Queen's Award for Export Businessmen, blah, blah, blah. And by this time, I was just dying to see what would happen if I shook hands and during the bow said, "Your Majesty, thank you very much for inviting us. And by the way, of which country is Lagos the capital?" And then I didn't think it looked too good in trade press. Businessman dragged away from Queen shouting, "It begins with an N! It begins with an N!" No, I said I don't want one, thanks.
It's okay, I can wait.
I beg your pardon?
You might in a bit. I'll wait. That's my job. I'm a waiter.
Greg, would you excuse me just 1 minute? Greg, what are you doing, please?
Not interrupting anything with Greg, am I?
Well, yes, potentially. Seeing as Greg owns one of the largest companies in the Northwest and I own a catering business, yes.
All right, so that was a business conversation, was it?
Yes, it was.
That's how the chairman of ICI does a deal, sprawled half naked over the chairman of BP popping grapes in his mouth.
I was showing him the product.
Oh, I see that from over there.
I thought you spent all last weekend on a PR exercise.
You what?
Well, this is catering PR, okay? So you can stop playing the jealous boyfriend. And anyway, in the business environment, you're not my boyfriend. Like you told him, you're a waiter.
Hello, sir, white a bit. Hello, sir, white or orange?
Sorry? No, I'm actually looking for a Janetta Scarry.
Oh, Janetta, yeah, she's... Kirsty?
Sorry? Do you know?
It's Hodge's friend.
All right. Well, I'm Ross, the babysitter. It's a bit of an unexpected excursion, this. I just need to say we're here before anyone sees me and thinks something's happened.
Nah. I'll tell her. Yeah, you go into the gardens, because there's a bit of a crush in there. You know, it's lovely gardens around the back, you know? Yeah, and I'll find Mrs. your mum, and tell her to come out. Yeah? It's lovely big gardens, you know? To play in, isn't it?
Can we go in the garden?
Would you?
Yes, no problem. It's no problem. Hodge, have you seen... where are you going?
The garden.
Why?
To kill something.
Eric, we need more crudités.
Find Janetta. Say her daughter's turned up. To come to the garden. Quick!
That was the last melon we had.
Hodge!
That way.
Have you not seen Hellraiser, then?
What? The garden's a crap.
I've not come out to look at flowers. I mean, Eric, am I being unreasonable?
Yeah, a crap?
What?
The gardens.
Will you shut up about the gardens?
I know, right? It's just that I know it'll upset you. You know, I'll be somebody who likes plants and that.
What upsets me, Eric, is how with me, okay, prawn mousse is more important than sex. How is some 40-year-old in there? Sex is more important than prawn mousse.
Hey, so let's have a drink about it.
I mean, what's going on?
I know. Let's go back, have a drink, talk it over. Eh? Like usual. Yeah? Yeah, because it won't be what you think, you know? Because the thing is that psychologically, I think, what bloke at A and... I don't know this.
Are you here to do magic?
Magic?
At the party.
Is there a party?
Will you do magic at mine?
You're having a party? No.
No, I'm playing hide and seek now.
Oh, God. Don't do this to me.
What else do you like playing?
What the hell? What's going on? Did you...
Sorry?
Well, I wasn't. Did you... Right, get away, please.
What?
Get away, I said. I said, get away.
Do you know her?
Look, get your bloody hands off this child before I call the police. Did he do anything?
He does magic.
Have you touched her?
What?
Come on. You've told her you do magic. You've got that far, you pervert. What else have you done?
I can find the immaturity to accept.
Ever! Ever! Ever!
It's a babysitter!
The what? The
babysitter. Hodge is going to do magic at my party.
Well, by the looks of it, I think he'll have succeeded in making our babysitter disappear. Kirsty, would you like to take Ross and find him a towel, please?
I've got my old clothes in the car.
Thank you.
Go on then. Follow me out. I thought he was... Well, you know who he was, but it doesn't matter what I think anyhow. So let's have it again.
I mean, turning up at school with presents was nothing, was it? Not compared to the attempted murder of a babysitter in an ornamental fountain. Well, come on! Don't do a bloody Zulu dawn on me. Let's get it over with.
You forget, Hodge. I lived 15 years with a man who'd never have considered getting his trousers wet to defend someone. Impress? Yes, oh, he was very good at impressing. But then they were usually young, you see, young women, so he could make a splash, send them starry. Refuel his ego with a quick sexual pit stop, then race off, leaving the poor dear like a crumpled fuel can. I've been used to the darker side of the male ego, Hodge. I don't think I can bawl out a man who just wants to protect his daughter.
She's the only thing I've ever done that I'm proud of.
Get out of the fountain, Hodge.
It was brilliant. It was just... You were totally brilliant. All of you. I want you to know, I could not have made this the success, the total fantastic success it's just been, without all of you. I know there are some people who wouldn't appreciate, but I know what part you've played in making this work. What you've all done, every one of you. Which is why I want you to be the first to know. Someone out there took quite a shine to Deleuze catering. And that someone just turned out to be no other than Greg Scarry, owner of Scarry's Biscuits. You know, Janetta's ex-husband. We really hit it off, really got on. And he has only asked me out to lunch. Well, you know what that means? He must want some catering doing. Because of everything you've done with this gig, I think we might have another one.